I've been discovering Hubitat Community Apps that are going to blow your mind. But before you get those, you're going to need the Hubitat Package Manager. It, in and of itself, is also a community app, but it's going to be necessary to get these things installed. In this video, we're going to show you how to get this set up and installed on your Hubitat device. Stay tuned. Okay, so here we are in my C8 test hub, and we're going to start by going over to the apps code. And in the upper right-hand corner, we'll do new app. And we're going to do an import. You want to copy and paste the link that's in the description below into the insert URL field. Click import, acknowledge the OK, and there you have it. Click save, and this may take a few minutes. Once it's finished saving, you're going to come over here to the apps code link, click that, and back on the left side menu, click on the apps menu item. Back to the right side, and we are going to click add user app, and you'll see Hubitat Package Manager. Let's go ahead and click that. Again, this is going to take a few minutes. Some of the nice things about the Hubitat Package Manager is it's going to let you automatically update, or if you want to, you can just select the ones you want to update when you want to. You don't have to have it be automatic. You can be in full control. So now that we got this, we've got Hub Security up. If you have Hub Security, you're going to want to turn these on. I don't have it on my test hub, so we're going to leave those turned off. Click done. You should see Hubitat Package Manager on your list. You might have to scroll for it. And we're going to click into that. And the first thing it's going to do is want to configure it by matching installed apps and drivers. This is going to start a discovery process. First part is it goes through and looks for all of the repositories that are holding Hubitat related content. So these are all available for apps and drivers. There's a ton of them here. And then after you're fully set up, you can also add custom repositories to the list as well. And a repository, for those of you that don't know, is just a place where you can get the apps and drivers that other community members might have created for the Hubitat. Okay, if you have any custom drivers, you're going to get your list here. Now, it is giving you a warning that says that there might be some ones that are incorrect. And what it's wanting us to do is go ahead and click the ones that we think are correct. So we're going to click these. I'm not going to assume that they're all up to date. I'm going to let it tell me what needs to be updated. So let's click next and done. Okay, so it just went through and that completes the setup. Now we're going to have to go back in one more time. Okay, so before we do anything else, let's go down and look at the Package Manager settings. If you have a change to your Hub Security, you can switch that on or off here. You can enable debug logging. And here you have the debug and text logging. When everything's running fine, I like to leave these off so it doesn't clutter up my logs. You can pick the time that you want to do the updates, even if you want it to happen automatically. And then here's a list of, remember, all of those repositories that we saw in the beginning. Here they all are again. You can leave them all connected, or you can turn some of them off if you don't care for all of them. You can also add a custom repository. Hopefully in the future, DIY Smart Home Guy is going to have its own repository of Hubitat. So you'll be able to add that there until such time that we would get it on this list. Click next and it's going to save your settings and you're back to the menu. And then you have the fully functioning Hubitat Package Manager. Okay, so we added our drivers and apps. The first place that I'd like to check is to see what updates are out there. And here's a list of updates that are available. We'll start off with this Inavelli here. And let's pop over to next. And we'll go next again. And it's installing all the updates. Again, this may take a couple of minutes on your hub. And updates are complete. We can click next. And we're back to the main menu. So one of the nicest parts about this, besides that update feature, is the ability to install packages. You can search by keywords, browse by tags, or if you have a URL directly to where that package is, you can enter that. Let's go ahead and use the search by keywords. Let's pretend that we're looking for a Honeywell thermostat. And here's a list of all the Honeywell thermostat drivers by all the people that have made them. So if you know which one you want, you're just going to go ahead and click OK. Here's the Lyric. That's a pretty popular one. All right. And we'll click next. Ready to install next. And then install, and you'll watch the install magic happen. Click next and we're done. We're back. We want to view the apps and drivers. There's our Honeywell. See this Fibaro Smart implant from the Reviving Your Old Security System video. This is where we did the testing for that as well. So there's that Honeywell Home that we just did. Let's go back to our main menu. And lastly, we're going to show you how to uninstall. And since we don't have anything on the Honeywell, we're going to take that away. And there you go. And the uninstall is complete. And we're done. Now, I should note that if you have any drivers or apps that are set up, that you actually have things in use. So if you have a device with the device driver in use, you're going to need to remove that device first before you remove the driver. And if you have an app that you have actively going, you need to make sure that app isn't actively doing anything before you do the install. You'll get warnings on that. And that's about it. I've left a link below to the actual help page over on GitHub, and there'll be a link below for the Hubitat community as well.
That about wraps it up. Don't forget to subscribe, and don't forget to hit like, and spank that bell icon if you're into that sort of thing. Over here are a couple of videos that we thought you might like. Until next time, cheers.